bribery. Yeah, we want to buy folks stuff to get their favor. Yeah, we want to bribe folk to love us. But remember, love is what you do, it ain't what you say. And that's what Satan accuses God of. Satan accuses God of bribing us. And so far, Job has passed the test. God was vindicated in the fact that Job loved him even without the stuff. Job still had his worships. Even without his family. And so there was only one more enemy of his life that Satan could test. I mean, because after all, if you haven't got good health, my God, you're in trouble. Yeah. And so God gave Satan permission to go and afflict him with this disease. The only condition was that you spare Job's life. Look at verse 6. The Lord said to Satan, behold, he's in your hand. But Satan and spare his life. So verse 7, Satan went out from the presence of the Lord, struck Job with painful bars from the sole of his foot to the crown of his head. That term is difficult to describe. That term for balls, we see it in Exodus as one of the plagues in Egypt. That same phrase, painful balls, is one of the covenant curses for disobedience noted in an incurable illness. Sores that ooze. He had fevers with chills. As were red and swollen from weeping. Couldn't sleep. Halfway out of your mind. Breath went bad. Teeth would fall out. Pain from the top of your head to the sole of your feet. The sickness was so bad that Job's own friends didn't recognize it. He began to weep. Tore their robes and sprinkled dust on their heads. He looked so bad that they reacted as people do when folk die. And from Job's perspective, there was no chance of recovery from this disease. Verse 8, he took a potsherd, piece of clay, and began to scrape himself. As he sat among the ashes, Job's wife, Sister Job, verse 9, asked the question, are you going to still hold on to your integrity? You just go ahead and curse God and die. Now, she was really telling him to do two things. Number one, first, abandon your faith. And secondly, commit suicide. Yeah, she said, let go, leave it. Why are you still trusting in the Lord? Look at what he got you, nothing but misery. And so folk will tell you that. Why are you going to that church and you suffering like you are? Okay? Giving that preacher all your money. Stay at home and spend it on some alcohol. Second suggestion was suicide. Curse God. And he'll kill you and get it over with. And again, Job's wife wasn't the object of the test, but she too was laying it on the line. Come on, be honest. Come on, Sister Job. She too lost all her children. Sister Job done lost all her money. Yeah, her change is strange. And she had to take care of her husband who was sick. Well, you know how it is. As long as you got money, as long as you got a little help, some folk will be there for you. But as soon as you get on your sick bed and your money gets strange, you gotta look for folk, you gotta hunt for folk. And so she had no one to hold on to. She had nobody to comfort, no more money in the bank. She said, look, boy, don't you just cuss God and die. Job said, baby, don't be foolish. You got to take the bitter with the sweet. And as it turned out, Job's faith was a real thing. Because of every word that Satan could dish out, didn't cause Job to reject God.
Yes.
Look at chapter 2, verse 10, and all this.
Yeah.
Job didn't sin with his lips.
Yeah.
He held on to God. No matter how miserable his life had become. And so the question on the floor, how can we follow Job's example? How can we hold on to God when trouble comes? When trials come? Tribulation? How can we do what Brother James tells us to do? Count it all joy. When you fall into divers temptations. First of all, the first point is you have to understand that all suffering isn't necessarily punishment for sin.
Yeah.
Some people do suffer for their sins.
Yeah.
Job said, I've seen it. Those who plow evil and those who sow trouble, they reap it. The Bible consistently confirms the fact that you're going to pay the consequences for your sin. Those who are sexually active, matter of fact, I was on TV the other day, one of the doctors said there are all kinds of bugs out there. Yeah, you go lay down on anybody, you're going to catch anything. Yeah, you can expect to deal with some sexually transmitted diseases. If you keep on drinking, expect your liver to fail on you. Yeah, you keep on driving drunk, expect to hit somebody. But when these things happen, they shouldn't ask God if God did it to them. No, that stuff you do yourself. It says those sinners are part of the denial process, which leads to those consequences. But God's moral laws are just as real as the physical laws. And so if you decide to jump from a 10-story building, expect to land on the pavement below. Then it won't be a good fall. Because the law of gravity is in place. The same is true with the principle of sowing and reaping. What you sow, you're going to show it. On the other hand, though God gives us some insight into Job, the fact that suffering is not always caused by our sin. The Job text teaches us that we need to be slow to judge, quick to forgive. That's our man, God, my servant, Job. And so when folk are going through stuff, pray for them. You don't know why they're going through what they're going through, but as long as the Lord deals with them, all things work together for good. To those who love the Lord. Secondly, not only remember that all sin is not caused by what you do, but secondly, remember God is in control. Yeah, he's in control. Text reveals the fact that Satan was the one who inflicted the pain. But he was only able to do what God allowed him to do. But notice also, Job's testing wasn't initiated by Satan. God was the one who pointed him out in the first place. Have you considered my servant, Job? Can God say that about anybody in here this morning? Can he point you out to the devil and say, test them and try them and see what they'll do? God didn't do it to be mean. He did it based upon their relationship. I know he loves me. I know he's faithful. Test him if you will. Try him if you will. Kind of like what Jesus told Peter. He said, Peter, Satan looking for you, buddy. Yeah, and guess what? I ain't pray for him not to get you. He said, my prayer is that you're what? Your faith. My prayer is that you hold on to your faith. And when your strength will come back and help you, brother. Now we never know the whys, but it's good to know, regardless of what you're going through, God is in control. Pastor Rich said, trust him and never doubt. Now, surely he will hear you. He'll bring you out. To Job said, I've learned some things. He said, I figured out that you can't choose whether or not you're going to suffer.
Yeah.
Job said, I learned that pain y'all might want to write that down and keep it somewhere. I said pain. It has a purpose. I learned that suffering is going to come. And you can go through it with God, or you can try to do it without him. But I don't know about you, but I'd rather have Jesus on board when I'm going through my storm. Even if he's somewhere sleeping, it's good to know I can go and wake him up at any time. But God doesn't sleep, and he doesn't slumber. Oh, what I've learned from Brother Job is that man that is born of a woman is of a few days. And those few days are full, come on in here, of trouble. He coming up as he were a flower. And he flees as if he were a shadow. And he never continues in one state. I've learned from Brother Job that if you receive good from the hands of God, every now and then you're going to receive some bad also. For the sun shines not only on the just, but it shines on the unjust. I've learned from this account of Job that when he has tried me, Job said, I'm going to come forward. And I'm coming forth as pure gold. I've learned from this record in the book of Job, sometimes though he slays, yet I'm going to trust in the Lord. I've learned, Brother Train, I've learned that my Redeemer lives. And at the last day, he's going to stand upon the earth. And I shall see him for myself. Mama Hall, when I see Jesus, amen. Amen. I've learned from Brother Job that I've got to wait until my appointed time, until my change comes. Because I realize God still sits high and he still lets roll. He's going to wipe all my tears away. God has the very last word. He's the Alpha and the Omega. He's my beginning and he's my end. I've come to understand my weeping may endure for a night.